Hey guys, Jessica here, the Furry Family Coach. In today's video, we are going to be talking about why your dog is licking their paw so much. Like, it can be incessant sometimes, right? So stick with me. All right, guys, so probably about a year ago, I did another video on my channel about how to calm your dog's itchy, like, paws, right? And it did pretty well. I'll link it in the description below. But I wanted to really talk more about, like, why your dog is licking their paws, because I actually recently, Kimberly, my dog, started licking her paws, like, a lot. And, I mean, not a lot, but enough where I was like, there's something going on here, right? And then I got an email from Dr. Becker with one of her blog posts about dog's itchy paws. I will link that in the description below as well. And as you know, or if you've been following me for any length of time, you do know that I absolutely love Dr. Karen Becker. She is the world's most followed veterinarian, and she's quite amazing. So if you've never heard of her, definitely check her out. But I want to talk briefly about a few reasons why your dog's paws may be itchy and when it is of, like, biggest concern to you. Now, there are going to be a couple of topics that I talk about in this video that I'm not going to go too terribly into detail with, but I want to plant the seed in your mind, right? And we can talk about them more. As a matter of fact, I will talk about them more on my Patreon. If you are not already on my Patreon, I definitely recommend you checking that out. You get all new and exclusive pet parent content over there. If you are a pet parent, it is a must. So definitely check that link out in the description. Okay, so first and foremost, cats lick their paws a lot because it's part of their grooming process. So that's fairly normal. Though cats can have allergies and can get irritated paws too, so you definitely want to check in on that if you have cats. You should be able to notice if your cat's paw pads seem like red or inflamed or irritated. You should be able to notice that in your cat. But cats licking their paws is part of their grooming routine, so that's pretty normal. You're going to see them do that probably multiple times a day. Dogs, on the other hand, it is not a normal part of their grooming routine. So when you notice your dog, like, if you get to the point where it's noticeable that your dog is licking their paws a lot, there's probably an issue going on. Now, if you notice that it's seasonal, if it happens around spring and summer, it could be due to environmental allergies. Just like we have allergies, your dog could have allergies, maybe to grass or pollen. There are different environmental allergies that your dog could have. That is a possibility. If it is something that has just started, or if it's something that you notice year-round, then it could be a food intolerance. So there are already two things that I want to talk about here. I'm gonna hold them for a minute, but it could be a food allergy or intolerance. These are often caused by the poor quality of ingredients that big pet food companies use. So it's not all, I don't want to say all, but most commercially available pet foods, kibbles, canned foods, are generally going to be using not great quality ingredients. A lot of the ingredients are considered adulterated and denatured, and those poor quality ingredients can lead to intolerances in the body. So that happens, like, a lot. Like, a lot. That is happening a lot more and more and more every year. Our dogs are suffering because of the poor quality ingredients in their food. Also, over-vaccination can even... So if you've ever had a dog that had a reaction to a vaccine, a noticeable reaction to a vaccine, there are other things going on in the body. Even if your dog didn't have a noticeable reaction to a vaccine, we know, like, there is significant evidence that skin irritation and itchiness is a significant symptom of vaccination, and very significant with over-vaccination. I am not an anti-vaxxer. Let me just put that out there. I don't want to say that. That is not the point of this video or any other video that I do. But I am anti-over-vaccination. There is a lot of information to learn about vaccinations, and this video is not about vaccinations, but I do want to plant that seed in your head. It is something I have talked about on this channel before, and I can link those videos in the description. It's also something that I've gone even more into detail with on my Patreon, so make sure you are checking that as well. But here is the kicker. Paw licking can actually be a sign of pain. So your dog could be trying to soothe pain. It doesn't even have to be on their paws. It doesn't necessarily mean that their paws are in pain. Just pain in the body in general, anywhere in the body, one of the symptoms could be your dog is licking their paws a lot. Also, if your dog is bored or anxious or has separation anxiety, that can also lead, or your dog could take those feelings and they can be manifest in paw licking as well. So there is a lot going on, a lot of different reasons as to why your dog could potentially be licking their paws. And I should say licking their paws excessively, because occasionally is normal, but excessively, we definitely want to look into that further. Another thing that I do want to point out, and Dr. Becker does too in her article, is that if you've recently taken your dog for a walk, if the pavement was really hot, their paw pads could have gotten burned. Check. But with the palm of your hand, put it on the pavement. If you can leave it on the pavement without it burning for 5, 6, 7, 8 seconds, then you should be good to go. If you put the bottom of your palm on the pavement and it burns your hand, it is going to burn the bottom of your dog's paw pads. Or you could have gone for a walk, maybe the pavement is totally fine, but you could have walked through, or your dog could have walked through something that is irritating their paws, whether that's a, you know, maybe a chemical fertilizer or a pesticide that has been sprayed on somebody's yard or in the park. Hope not, but could have gotten through something maybe corrosive, maybe somebody's car is leaking antifreeze or something. Be aware of your surroundings, I guess is what I'm saying. And it's always a good idea anytime you go for a walk to really, you know, rinse and clean off your dog's paw pads when you get home. Even if you don't noticeably walk through something nasty, your dog's paw pads are going to be dirty by the time you get home. So it's probably a good idea to just give them a quick rinse. Even, you know, chemical-free, pet-safe wipes would be a good idea to wipe your dog's paw pads off after a walk. Fleas, ticks, other parasites can also irritate your dog's paw pads, so you can definitely check for that as well. We do want to resolve excessive licking because it really can wind up bad. Like, your dog could wind up harming themselves due to excessive licking. Of course, we want to identify the underlying condition first, but it could also lead to your dog harming themselves by creating hot spots or something worse. A yeast infection can also be a big cause of your dog licking their paws excessively. Again, this could be due to an imbalance in the gut microbiome. It could be due to the food they're eating. One thing that you can do is have them tested for food sensitivities. On Dr. Becker's blog, she says, paw licking can be a pain signal for dogs, even if the pain occurs in another part of the body. Trauma, such as a fracture, post-surgical discomfort, a foreign body, insect bites, arthritis, nail bed infections, nerve damage, or cancer can all trigger pain and related excessive licking. Of course, there are also behavioral issues and psychological issues that could lead to excessive licking as well, like we talked about earlier. Bottom line, if your dog is excessively licking their paws, I definitely recommend that you seek the assistance of a holistic or integrative veterinarian. A conventional veterinarian may not be too terribly helpful in this arena. They could give your dog steroid injections. They will probably never recommend a diet change. While, you know, if a conventional veterinarian is all you have access to, I understand. Take your dog to your vet, talk to them, but do your own research as well. Again, a holistic or integrative veterinarian, I personally believe, is going to be your best bet in this situation to help you really get to the bottom of it, because we don't want to put a band-aid on it, right? We want to actually treat the cause. The paw licking, the excessive paw licking, is a symptom. We want to treat the cause. If you go to a conventional veterinarian, they're just generally, not all, but generally just going to treat the symptom, which is the paw licking. And we really need to pay attention to and attend to the underlying condition that is causing your dog to excessively lick their paws. Otherwise, we're just going to continue this cycle over and over and over again. All right, guys, I do hope this video was helpful for you. Please make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you aren't already subscribed, please make sure you are subscribed. I also really hope to see you over on Patreon. We can talk so much more about so many different topics that I just spoke briefly about in this video. I talk about it all there over on Patreon. So make sure you check out the link for my Patreon and join me over there. Also, I can't do this without you guys. This whole channel is for you. My goal for 2021 is to get this channel to 25,000 subscribers, and I can't do it without your help. Please make sure that you are subscribed, and anybody in your life that you know who has pets and may be able to use some of the information on this channel. I talk about dog training, dog behavior, canine enrichment, canine nutrition, and I talk about our cats sometimes too because I love them all. Then this channel is for them. I hope you share it with them as well and encourage them to subscribe. Thank you so much for being here with me today. I can't wait to see you in the next video and over on Patreon. See you later, guys. Hey, thanks for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you never miss another video.